Because during Amin's time, so many people were being killed, people were suffering.
It was on the night of February 16th, 1977, when Archbishop Janan Luwum was murdered at Nakasero by then Ugandan President Idi Amin. Archbishop Janan Luwum was the head of the Anglican Ecclesiastical Province, which by then was composed of four countries, including Burundi, Eastern Congo, Rwanda, and Uganda. On the night of February 5th, soldiers stormed the Archbishop's residence at Namirembe, claiming to be looking for hidden weapons. However, nothing was found. In response, all bishops assembled at Namirembe and wrote a letter to Idi Amin on February 8th, which made him angry. On February 14th, Amin sent a cabinet minister to collect the Archbishop from Namirembe and take him to State House in Entebbe, where he was very hostile and insulted Luwum before releasing him to be returned to Namirembe. Following his disappearance, it was later on the morning of February 17th revealed by the government in a statement that the Archbishop and two ministers had died in a car accident. Dr. Olara Otunu, who was a close friend to Archbishop Luwum, says the government statement was a total lie.
The actual assassination took place at Nakasero by Idi Amin. Dug a grave at Namirembe. That's where the family and the church was preparing to lay him to rest. But unknown to them, Idi Amin had now instructed for the remains to be taken to Muchuni. They arrived in Muchuni when it was now dusk, getting dark. So they were afraid that if the local people got to know the purpose of their arriving in Muchuni, there might be commotion.
Otunu says they used to meet on several occasions.
When I was studying right here, on this very hill, here at Bunda, he was then the provincial secretary, the prime minister of the church. He would come to visit me here at Bunda. Later, when I was abroad, he was now Archbishop. When he came abroad, especially when he came to London on church matters, he would link up with me, would meet, he would advise, he would guide.
Ben Luwum, who is the elder son of the Archbishop Janan Luwum, said that his father had love for his religion.
He was really dedicated to his religion. That one I have no doubt about, because he used to devote most of his time to his religion. When he was a reverend, when he was a bishop, he had no time to go and look for his own personal money, even to buy food. Food was being organized by Christians.
Ben says, due to his kindness, Amin misinterpreted his father until the day he died.
Because during Amin's time, so many people were being killed, people were suffering. But because he was a kind man, people would go to him, ask the bishop of Ngulu, first of all, I used to see, and ask the archbishop. People used to go to him whenever somebody is arrested to try to talk to the officials or even Amin himself to rescue. That was kindness.
Ben says Archbishop Luwum looked after them very well as a father.
He was really on us all the time as his children. He would concentrate on what we are learning at school, to see how we are doing at school. Because if you are doing badly, you need support. Yeah, but fortunately, I think for me, I was dedicated to my school and he loved me.
Dr. Olara Otunu says Archbishop Luwum was a unifier and a human rights defender regardless of one's faith.
He never discriminated and said, these are Catholics, these are Anglican, these are Pentecostal, these are Muslim. Never. He brought everybody together. And he was an unbelievably brave human rights champion. He faced President Idi Amin asking, where is so-and-so? How come so-and-so has been killed?
Otunu narrates that Luwum's death also led to the liberation of Ugandans from Idi Amin's regime.
It is his martyrdom that galvanized the entire international community to say, we have been taking lightly the situation in Uganda. If this is what has now happened, we cannot accept. Without his martyrdom, it would have been very difficult for Ugandan political forces to unite in the effort to remove Idi Amin.
Since 2015, Wigweng has also been the venue for national and international commemoration of St. Janan Luwum Day, marked on February 16th every year. Dr. Olaro Tunu says that plans to develop Luom's tomb located at Wigweng in Kitgum District are on.
This is the master plan. We are now ready to launch and begin the first phase of this plan. So the first phase is going to concentrate on four items from this master plan. The tomb, there's no tomb at the moment. There's the burial place, the grave. So over the grave should be built an appropriate tomb. And we hope to get an artist to do a sculpture, a life-size sculpture of the Archbishop at Wigweng.